And here in the Bay Area, strong winds toppled trees in San Francisco. That's in the Presidio. Part of the road there was closed to traffic so crews could come out and clear it all out. And a mix of rain and hail in the North Bay. That is video out of Marin, which got pounded by that this afternoon. It was a week ago that Darren said there'd be big changes this weekend. And boy, were there.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out, too. And we're pretty much done with it. We're not going to get any more rain or hail. The worst of the wind is over. The snow has stopped falling, and yes, it snowed on Mount Hamilton. So take a look at the picture. This is just about 4,000 feet up above Santa Clara Valley. You can see the water of the South Bay right there. So San Jose, Santa Clara, all those communities are back here. Mount Hamilton, there's a long and winding road to get up there. The Lick Observatory, a very historic monument for us, sits up here. That's about 4,000 feet high, and the snow is in the hills down, if I was going to guess, probably down close to the 3,000-foot level. Kind of pretty. It's not going to last long, and there's no more coming. I'll show you that system here on the high-def Doppler. This is what it looked like today. Between about 12 o'clock this afternoon and 4 o'clock this afternoon, pretty impressive band of showers, kind of in an organized line, isolated lightning and small hail. We've shown you the beautiful pictures that people have shared from all over the Bay Area today, but that was the last of it, and that line has now left. And if you look at the sky, this is our exclusive vantage point from the top of the Mark Hopkins Hotel, looking off towards the north. And if we look back down towards the southeast, you get a beautiful view back over the shoulder of the Salesforce Tower. And if we go to the top of the Salesforce Tower and look off to the east, you get the clear picture here. We're done. So what's left? All the cold air. And that's what's going to be different now. So the system that brought all this in with it, all the cold air is rushing in behind it now. And the temperatures on the thermometer don't really reflect the issue. There's a frost advisory tonight because of this. Specific to the North Bay, you can see those sheltered valleys there, right? Going up along 101 up into Napa. Sheltered valleys, meaning you don't get much access to the influence from the bay. You're not going to get much of a breeze. And we'll see temperatures dip down into the 20s. Look at the high resolution temperatures on here. You get into those deep shades of blue, like the valley here, Santa Rosa, Rona Park, Petaluma, that's where the coldest air just kind of settles down to the low spots and sits there. We're not going to be quite that cold everywhere. In fact, if we put some numbers on it, you'll see we've got to go down to 30 in Santa Rosa tonight. But it'll only be 35 in San Rafael. It's only going to be 46 in the city. That's what we mean by sheltered valleys up there. You look at the rest of the Bay Area, and while it's going to be cold, Concord, you're going to 35. It'll be 34 in Livermore. It's Santa Rosa that's really going to be the coldest, and we're going to do it for the next couple of mornings. It'll be 31 on Tuesday morning, and then it'll gradually improve by the end of the week. Speaking of which, by the end of the week, we've got another opportunity for rain. Daytime highs tomorrow, that's going into Monday, by the way, and they're going to be right around what morning lows used to be, right around 60. There's no change in the daytime highs. Here's the next item of interest. That's the accumulated rainfall for Northern California from Thursday afternoon into Saturday. Doesn't have to play out exactly this way, but this is our next look ahead now to our next chance of rain. The pattern is staying progressive. In other words, we're continuing to see, on like a 5 to 6 day period here, another weak little system comes into Northern California and gives us another shot at rain. And just like the last two that have done this, the best of it's going to be up here. But look, we've got a chance here in the city. And the more we can put in the Sierra, the better it is. Because that's, you know, where one of the major risks for fire weather would be. And we're really starting to whittle away the fire risk with these systems that come in. We haven't got everybody yet with the amount of rain we need. But I think we're getting it where it matters most, which is good news. All right, in the 7-day forecast, you can see that chance of rain there Thursday and Friday. And look at the end of it. A daytime high near 70 inland. It's going to be 59 tomorrow, so we'll get a nice warm-up, too, by the time we get to next weekend. And whatever this next system on Thursday and Friday is going to bring, we'll have already brought it by then.